Thank you. Thank you. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Thank you. Hare Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna.
gimana? Gimana?
Haribo.
Once we'll be given to translate us. Jagat nirandhasya jnananjana samakaya chakshurunmitam yena asmai shivirave namaha vamsa kalpatarubhyascha kripasindhubhyaiva cha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo mahavadanyaya krishnaprayamaprayate krishnaya krishna vannadamne gaurakthise gurave gaurachandraya radhikaya yuddhadalaya krishnaya krishna bhaktaya adbhaktaya namo yam prabhyantamanupetamabhivakasyam dvaipānyamohivahakākarayādhyāha putreti tannayacarākarvobhinedho tam sarvabhotaridayam munimānyam first of all, I so many Dhanvat Pranam in the lotus feet of my spiritual master and Srila Bhakti Vedanta Bhakti Prajnan Keshava Goswami Maharaj and same in the lotus feet of Nitya Leela Parishwam Vishnu Parashishwam Bhakti Vedan Swami. About some more than 5,000 years ago, in India, on the bank of Gomti River, 88,000 rishis were assembled there. And they were discussing each other how that is Kali Yuga is coming. Oh, at that time so many religions like Sundabadi, they will tell that the world has come from nothing. The world is nothing. And in the world, in the end, world will be nothing. And the ladies will give up their chastity. In day to day they will give up their husbands and change their husbands. Men also will give up their religion. that is also give up their wives. Then son will not tell that who is my father. In this way, this iron Yuga is coming, Kali Yuga is coming. The age of the Kali Yuga persons will be very short. And what they will do, for good it will be bad. O Sutta Goswami, you are disciple of Srila Sukadeva Goswami. You have read Bhagavatam, read Upanishad, Quran and everything from him. You know. So we are asking you how our soul will be happy. Please tell us.
那么在五千多年前在印度，在恒河岸边，大概有八万和八千个人顺德在那里齐聚一堂，并且互相讨论即将的卡利年代的来临。那么当时的话呢，也是因为瓦底这些虚无主义者、这些宗教，他们说世界是来自于虚无，也最终归于虚无。那么他们女人放弃了贞洁，这种最美好的品质，因此他们随便的抛弃丈夫。男人也放弃宗教，也放弃自己的妻子，儿子甚至分不出谁是我的父亲。因此卡利年代的来临，那么这时候呢，苏萨沟双米是苏萨沟双米的门徒。那么当时那些齐聚一堂的圣德就向他询问我们怎样才能够呢，就是说什么是我们的终极目标等等这些命题了。
You know that in this world, what to tell man and woman, even all the living beings, they want to be happy. They don't want to suffer. To be happy, nowadays, scientists have done so many wonderful inventions. You know that transportation by aeroplane in an hour we can go one place to another place. Also, you can see what the President of China or Russia or America Bush is. What is speaking, you can see his picture and see what he is saying. Scientists have done so marvelous things that if your heart is somewhat defected, another heart they can have. If you have something wrong, they can change your gait also. Why? To be happy. They have invented atom bombs, nitrogen bombs. You know that America put a bomb in Japan and whole Hiroshima was finished. Why? That I will finish others, my enemies, and I will be happy. So now America is saving from all. You cannot go into America easily. So many bans. So, also China has developed his science. He has made so many bombs and everything. Now he is very, very powerful. It seems that he will be more powerful than America also. But none is happy. Anyone cannot shake. It's old days, coming old days. You must be old. and one day you will have heaven. To give up all your body deeds, not a single farthing you can take from this world. Like junkies who are dying of hard labor, but far, far, far they go. This is not the process of being happiness. So, we should think how our soul will be happy, not this body. For body, we take alcohol. What did I say? Alcohol. Alcohol. We take meat, fat, so many things, bad things. But still we are not happy. We should think that we are not this body. One day it will be old and give up. And give up this body. Not a single farthing you can take from this world. Empty handed you will have to go. So, the rishis are thinking how a soul can be.
在这个世界哈，无论是男女的话呢，都追求快乐。那么其他生物体一样的，想得到快乐，不想受苦。那么科学家现在有很多的发明，像飞机啊哈，我们现在运输工具，然后呢，一个小时就能够很快的到达另外一个地点。像中国哈、俄罗斯和美国，那么个互相之间的语言呢、都能够经过哈科技的一个协助的话呢，互相能够沟通。那么科学家也能够呢哈。通过了这个心脏手术来弥补了一些心脏方面的疾病以及呢更换器官等等这方面的一些问题。那么他们也呢发明了一些致命性的武器，像原子弹。那我们知道美国在40年代的话呢，曾经向日本广岛呢投放了这个原子弹，导致了呢千万人的这个丧生。所以以这种呢毁灭别人为以毁灭别人作为快乐的代价，那么这就是这个现在这个物世界的这种的所谓快乐。那么中国现在呢也发展了它的科技，甚至日益也变得强大，甚至有一日呢能超过美国。但是呢没有人能够快乐，老年会来的，终有一日呢我们要放弃这个世界，连一根毛发也不能够带走。所以这不是快乐的真正程序。我们怎样才能够灵魂怎样才能够快乐？那么为了身体的快乐，我们去喝酒吃肉，但是我们永远不会快乐。我们不应该想着自己这个身体，因为我们最终呢毫毛不能够带走。
Hearing this question, Sukh Goswami became very happy. And he remembered the sweet pastimes of Krishna. And then he did pranam to his Gurudev Sukadev Goswami and began to serve. स्वपै पुंसान करो धर्मो जसो भक्ति लघोक खजे अहे तो कब जब ही ताज भक्ति पुरुषो।
那么针对呢圣哲门的那个询问的话呢，苏陀沟沙弥呢非常的喜悦了，所以他冥想了一种甜美的逍遥时光，并且顶拜他的灵性导师苏陀沟沙弥，然后呢说出了下面的这个引述的经文。
स्वयं पुंसान परो धर्मो जतो भक्ति व भोक्खजे अहित तो तप गमिता जो भक्ति पुरुषो certainly the highest class of religion of whole entity living entity especially for man and woman to serve Adhokhaj Vishnu, Adhokhaj Tattva, which cannot be realized by senses. But is that continuous, like a stream of honey,
and without any cause,
worldly cause,
no worldly desire. This is the highest cause of religion of the whole world. Another shloka, Srila Rupa Goswami has told, Anya Abhilashita Sunnam Jnana Karmat Janabhitam Anukulleni Krishna Anusiranam Bhakti Rupa. You should explain very...
那么这个经典哈引述的是圣典《国家瓦坛》里面引述的一个细节了。他说：“肯定的，众生最高的宗教呢，尤其是对人类而言最高的宗教，是对哈自尊主的这个呢莲花主的服务。那么这种服务呢，不能够被呢感官或是感官所触碰，而且是呢没有物质缘由哈，没有匮乏世俗欲望，毫不中断的哈这种呢这种服务。那么这也被称为呢是最高的宗教。”
So they speak in a very simple language that all men and gentlemen
Om Jnana Simiram Dasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurum Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha वंशाकल्पस्वरूपश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यश्च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः First of all, I'm offering my unlimited dandavat pranams to the lotus feet of my beloved Gurudev, Nityalila Pravishta Om Vishnupad Ashto Sarasata Sri Srimad A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj Prabhupad.
首先我向我的灵性导师 Om Vishnupad Nityalila Pravishta Om Vishnupad Ashto Sarasata Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupad 的莲花主呢致以呢好敬拜。
And then I'm offering my equal pranams, dandavat pranams to the lotus feet of my beloved Siksha Gurudevs.Nityalila Pravishtom Vishnupad Srishila Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Goswami Maharaj and Om Vishnupad Astro Tarasata Srishila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, whom we have the unlimited good fortune to be here in this assembly hearing from his divine lotus mouth.
Nityalila Pravishtom.Bhakti Raksha Shiva Maharaj 的莲花主顶拜，以及向我们的灵性导师 Srila Gurudev Sri Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj 顶拜。
Who we have the good fortune.
Yeah, 我们有这个好幸运呢，能够呢得到他的怜悯。
So Srila Gurudev has been traveling throughout this entire world for 12 years, distributing this message of Krishna Bhakti.To all of human society.
那么顾建哈连续十二年以来的话呢，都就是周游同教哈，去传播呢这种关于 Krishna Bhakti 哈，就关于 Krishna 的奉献服务这种呢信息。
He is representing the ancient teachings of the Vedas, which are especially given in the great literature called Srimad Bhagavatam.
那么他给出的这个信息的话呢，哈，就是是古老的哈，伟大的这个呢，经注哈，尤其是呢，圣典《博伽瓦坛》里面的哈信息。
These teachings of the Srimad Bhagavatam have been revered for thousands of years in the land of India, and in the last 40 years, they have been translated into English and many other languages, and now people of the world are hearing this very important message.
那么呢，这种哈。超人知识的话哈，在印度呢，数以千年来哈，都被呢，就是说揭露。那么如今哈，最近的四十年的话呢，也被翻译成了哈英文以及其他语言呢，广为传播。
All knowledge for the benefit of human society is given in the Vedas, and the essence of all knowledge by which human beings can attain the highest happiness, the highest good in their life, it is given in this scripture.
那么所有教导的精华的话呢，对人类教导精华的话呢， 尤其是对，就是说对众生而言哈，那么都包含在了这本称为呢圣典薄伽瓦含的这个经部里面。
And it is recommended in this scripture that this knowledge it should be heard from the lips of a pure God realized person, someone who is living the teachings, not just only theoretical.
那么经典里面推荐的话呢，这种知识哈，一定要呢去从那个就是说已经觉悟的灵魂呢，这纯粹的奉献者那里去呢聆听，而不是只是理论上的，对吧
？So here in this assembly, we're very fortunate because such a personality is present with us, and he is going to be explaining these teachings to us for the following 5 days.
那么的话呢，哈，这里我们非常有幸的哈，有这样一位呢，就是说。伟大的人物了，那么来到这里哈，给我们解释这东西，在未来的五天之内。
We have just come from the sacred land of India, where we had a grand assembly of every day 15,000 to 20,000 people who were coming to hear this very same message from our beloved Gurudev.
那么我们刚刚从哈印度呢哈这个圣地呢来到这儿哈，那么之前的话呢，我们在那里哈，这个朝拜活动每天哈也有15,000到20,000人哈来聆听了Guruji的讲经。
So out of his cosmos mercy, he has now come here to this land of China to distribute this message for the benefit of all the people of China.
那么出于他的恩典哈，那么他来到了中国哈这片土地了，来的传播哈这种的知识。
So Srila Gurudev has begun.To explain the very beginning of this book, Srimad Bhagavatam, wherein 5,000 years ago there was a very great assembly of very, very learned, very knowledgeable transcendentalists. Many thousands of transcendentalists were gathered together, and amongst themselves they selected one personality who was the topmost amongst them, and his name was Suta Goswami.
那么刚才哈，希罗古典呢也提到了哈，在圣典薄伽瓦含的开篇了，那么讲到了哈，千计万计的这个圣德哈。
这是一种。
And also, he has heard from Sukadeva Goswami. Otherwise, so many rishis are more superior than
Suta Goswami.
Yes.
那么刚才哈呢，他妈妈就讲到了哈，这些呢就是说当时在聚会的时候，很多圣德哈来聆听呢，Suta Goswami讲经，那么他是其中他是最高的，但是Guruji哈指出来这是错的，而当时听经者里面呢有相当多的哈，这个呢就是。顶尖的人物哈，甚至呢超越这个讲经者呢，苏他都刷米。但是因为他哈被推荐为讲经者，是因为他从了苏他都刷米那去听过这本经典，所以他被推荐为然后主讲者。
So in this particular assembly, the great sage Shonaka Rishi, he asked questions on behalf of all these learned sages. He asked some questions to Suta Goswami.But specifically, he asked him the question, how all human beings, all of human society, how can they attain happiness in this very difficult time of Kali Yuga?
那么当时呢，一位圣德的哈，那么就代表呢其他所有的圣德的哈，向呢苏哈高沙米提问，在这个哈，就是说这个年代里面哈，什么是哈对众生哈最为有益的哈这个最高的这宗教
？Because as Srila Gurudev explained.They saw that this age of Kali was now coming, and there would be so many problems and so many difficulties for people to attain real happiness of their eternal souls.
那么Guruji哈，刚才他提到了，也就是在这个卡利年代的话呢，哈，为了就是说众生呢，哈，为了得到他们永恒的哈，这个他们灵魂永恒的快乐的话呢，是相当困难的哈，有很多障碍等等。
So therefore, they requested Suta Goswami to tell very clearly.What process they can follow in their lives so that the atma samprasidati, their atma, their eternal soul will become satisfied, not just this physical body.
所以当时呢哈，他就询问了我应该追随什么样的程序哈，才能让atma哈灵魂本身的快乐，而不是哈这个身体的。
So then, Sudha Goswami, he answered the question by saying this verse. Savaipun sang paro dharmo yato bhaktir abhokshaje ahoituki aprasihata jayatma samprasidati. Here he explains that the highest principle, the highest activity, which is called paradharma, for all of human society, doesn't matter which race, which country, even which so-called religion that they belong to, but the highest dharma, the highest duty of every living being is to perform pure bhakti, pure devotion to the Supreme Being, Adhokshita.
那么呢，这里面提到了哈，就是无论呢他是哪一个种群的哈人了，就是说哪个国家的人，或者是哪种文化、哪种宗教的人，那么他的高马哈，就是最高的宗教是什么呢？是然后去至尊主哈做出呢这个奉献服务哈。Now
it's very significant that Sri Goswami used the word Adhokshita to address this Supreme Being.
那么呢，他用的是 Adhokshita这个词哈来呢称这个至尊人物。
As Gurudev explained, Abhoksaja means that supreme eternal being who has created everything that we can see around us, and he is transcendental to everything. By our senses, by our mind, we cannot directly perceive him. He is beyond our senses and our mind, but he is existing in his eternal spiritual realm.
那么刚才呢，哈，Shri的规律呢也提到了哈，这一位至尊人物的话呢，虽然他创造了哈整个宇宙，整个创造都是由他创造，但是的话呢，他超越于的哈这个物质存在，并且他有他的自尊居所。So
Sudha Goswami came immediately to the point. What exactly should the soul, the eternal soul, do so that they can connect their soul with the supreme soul?
所以的话呢，实际上说他够双明呢，就直接哈讲到了怎样子呢，灵魂哈才能跟超灵呢直接哈联系关联。And
immediately he told, "Yato bhaktir adhokshaje." Here he is telling that the process that every soul can be united with the supreme soul is through the process of bhakti yoga.
那么呢，他讲到了哈，个体灵魂与超灵的哈连接这个方式的话呢，就是集邮了哈 bhakti yoga 啊，就富汉瑜伽。
And he explained here that this bhakti, meaning pure devotion, pure love for that supreme being, it can be cultivated by anyone when they perform bhakti without any other motivation other than to please that supreme being.
那么当一个人哈，从事呢这个呢奉献服务哈，毫无呢就是个人私欲的哈，那么这时候呢。 那么他是能够培育的哈，这种对至尊神的爱，或者说奉献的情感。He
mentioned ahoituki aprasihata, two things: that this pure devotion should be rendered to the supreme being, purely for his satisfaction, and also it should be constantly done. Not that it is only done once every week or a few minutes a day, but here he is telling 24 hours. Constantly flowing uninterruptedly, just like when you pour from a jar of honey, you pour honey, and it flows in an unbroken stream. He said, bhakti to the Supreme Lord has to be like this.
我们这里面讲到了哈，奉献服务有两个特征的，一个呢是为了取悦哈至尊主，所做的啊至尊神所做的，他为了他的快乐而做；第二个呢是他不中断的哈，实际上呢这个蜂蜜哈，从那蜂蜜罐里面呢流出来哈，它是一个不间断的这种24小时，而不是哈一天一个星期哈做一次或。
So he explained, when anybody will render such pure bhakti to the Supreme Being, what will be the result? Ye atma samprasidati. Their atma will become completely happy, completely satisfied, fully.
那么当一个人哈，对至尊主呢，做出这一类型的哈程序奉献服务的时候，那么他的阿卡哈，他的灵魂呢，就完全了哈满足。
Just like Srila Gurudev explained, nowadays, in this material world, we see that there have been so many advances technologically in human society. He explained transportation, communication, medical, everything. But have people actually attained happiness from this? No. No matter how much technological advancement one gets, he cannot be happy on the level of the soul.
那么刚才呢，其实的顾瑞哈也讲到了呢，关于呢科技的发展哈，这些物质的东西哈，包括交通啊，医学等等的进步，不能够给这个灵魂在灵魂层面上哈给予我们快乐。
So truly, this message of Srimad Bhagavatam, it is meant for the benefit of all of human society, for all time to come, because we are all eternal beings, eternal souls. We are not these physical bodies. And our relationship with the Supreme Being, with the Supreme Absolute Lord, that is eternal. So this process of bhakti is the only process by which the soul can fully attain his eternal position of happiness.
那么这里面的知识的话呢，就是说呢，它是就也是指向未来的，因为我们是永恒的存在。那么我们跟自身土的话，这种关系的话呢，也是永恒的。那么得到这种快乐的话呢，就只能集由这种的程序是的。
So in our line of spiritual masters, which have come down from that time, from 5,000 years ago, there is a whole disciplic succession of gurus, teachers, who have themselves perfected this knowledge in their lives.And now they are teaching it to the whole human society.
那么在五千年前一直到现在只有这个传递的话呢，那么很多人在这条传递里面就达成他们的完美并且传播这类型的知识。
So Ashur Gurudev, he is the current representative of this long unbroken chain of perfect spiritual masters coming for 5,000 years.
那么现在 Gurudev 的话呢，也是呢我们这个年代这个代表了，也就是说整个没有中断的这条呢是传系的现今的代表。
And about 500 years before, a very great personality appeared within this world named Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
那么大约在500年前一位伟大的人物了名字叫呢 Sri Mahaprabhu 那么他诞生。
And he is an incarnation of the Supreme Lord Krishna himself.And he has come to teach this process for all in this age of Kali.
那么他呢是去 Krishna 这个化身了。那么他呢教授卡利年代的众生呢他的宗教程序。
So he explained very clearly to one of his chief disciples, Srila Rupa Goswami. He explained this whole science of bhakti so that everybody can clearly understand in their lives how they can apply this.
那么他向他这个门徒如果说明了讲述到了这些东西，那么他们就非常能够清晰的看看这个程序怎么走，怎么达到目标。
So Srila Gurudev mentioned one verse that was composed by Rupa Goswami, which actually explains in perfect detail how all of us may apply the process of bhakti in our lives to attain this perfect happiness.
那么是顾瑞刚才引述了这个卢帕布沙米的一个著名的经典那么尽力的呢纯粹奉献服务并且呢讲到我们怎么运用于我们这个修行里面。
That verse is as follows.
那么这十节呢如下。
Anya vilashita shunyam jnana karmadi anavritam anakulyena krishnanu shilanam bhaktir uttama. So here Rupa Goswami has explained.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Very good
explanation.
Guruve Gaura Chanda Radhika Dhrale Krishna Krishna Bhaktaya Tadivaktaya Namo Namaha. First of all, I offer blessings to Srila Gurudev.
Srila Gurudev,
Srila Nisanyasi Brahmachari.
在座的
徐
三
弟三亚姐
和
张超也好，
顶拜。
A weighing machine. We can understand how much I am far from pure devotion or close.
那么呢Gurudev说呢这是像个测量仪一样我们知道我们就是说这个世界像测量仪一样，你知道呢你真的奉献服务，纯粹奉献服务还有多远。
And this morning we explained something.
那么今天早上呢我们讨论到了一些。
Anya bilasita sunyam jnana karmadi labhatam anukulena krishnanu shilanam bhakti uttama. This means devotion.There are two parts of this verse, the internal side and the external side. But first we discuss the internal part. Here we are referring to Uttam Bhakti, the topmost form of devotion. That will exclude everything which is not pure devotion. What is the internal symptoms of such devotion? That means devotion should be performed by the activities of the body, mind, and words.
那么这种奉献服务呢，是由呢身口意哈三者呢去进行的。
And emotion,
还有呢你内在的情感,
which are performed exclusively for the benefit of Krishna.
那么这时候呢是就是说呢非常袍外的哈，只是为了呢Krishna的喜乐而做的啊，排除其他东西的。
Such devotion will not be covered by materialistic fruitive activities called karma.
这种呢奉献服务呢不被呢karma哈就果报活动呢所覆盖。
It will not be covered by jnana, impersonalistic knowledge. It will be performed unbrokenly. There will be no other desires except the desire to give happiness to Krishna. Therefore, what is the surup lakshana or the internal symptoms of this verse? Just like we know the external activities of devotion are like chanting Harinam, hearing class, worshipping the deity. But what is the internal mood? That is very important also. Therefore, Sri Rupa Goswami says, devotion is only for Krishna, no one else.
如果是上面也讲到了奉献服务呢只是为了Krishna不为了其他人的。
That means it should not be done for mother or father, the forefathers, ghosts, spirits, any demigods, any person in this world, no one, only Krishna.
那么这是意味着你这些活动不是呢为了你的父母亲或者是祖先还有其他鬼魂天还有棒神而做。
If devotion is given to anyone else, even fractionally, it cannot be called pure devotion. Then it will be mixed devotion.
如果这种活动呢有部分呢已经给予了其他人那么这种活动不能够称为呢纯粹的奉献服务而非称为呢混杂型的奉献服务。
Even that means other incarnations like Ram, Nrisimhadev, Krishna and Dwarka, even they cannot be called. This cannot be called Uttam Bhakti. Uttam Bhakti is only for Krishna and Vrindavan.
甚至呢你为其他的化身包括主 Ram, Nrisimhadev 等等而做的话呢都不能够称为的
Therefore, this verse indicates there should be something done for Krishna.
所以的话呢，这里面讲的哈，应该做一些的哈，为Krishna做的事。
Anusilanam. Silanam means a cultivation of activities and emotions for Krishna.
那么这里面讲的哈，培育活动哈，为了Krishna培育一些活动。
That should have the symptoms. It should be pratikul or hip. It should be devoid of feelings of envy towards Krishna. It should be done in a mood which is favorable to Krishna. There is Bhav Rupa and Chest Rupa. Chest Rupa means there should be cultivation of external activities. Like I am now chanting about Krishna. And you are hearing about Krishna. And thinking about Krishna. That means we are engaging our, we are performing some endeavor, some chesta for Krishna's happiness.
Therefore,
cultivation means these activities, hearing, chanting, remembering, worshipping.
因此呢，就是说这些活动呢，包括唱诵、聆听、崇拜等等，培育这些活动。
Like in Buddhist philosophy, only they meditate, but not doing anything for Krishna's happiness.
那么在佛教里面，他们做的冥想打坐比较多，就没有做任何活动，为了Krishna做任何活动。
But there should not just be external activities, there should be Bhav Rupa, cultivating emotions towards Krishna.
那么除了这外在活动之外的话，还应该有内在的情感，
This is called Silanam. Silanam means cultivation.
因此呢，称为呢Silanam，培育。
Rupa Goswami says anusilanam. Anu means continuously perform. Not 1 hour Hare Krishna, then 3 hours television, then half an hour Hare Krishna, then sleeping 10 hours, no. Pure devotion should not be part of our day, it should be our whole day. Anu means also anugatya moya. There should be guidance. For example, if you want to cook a meal for Gurudev, and you spend many hours cooking, and you cook chicken, this, that, the Gurudev doesn't eat chicken, you have done so much hard work that it could not reach Gurudev, because he doesn't take that.
那么如果你为Gurudev煮一汤，然后呢有很多鸡啊，这些动物的成分，但是他不吃这些东西，你很累，但是也没有了，不接受。In
this world, people are doing so many things for God, but they don't know what makes God happy, therefore their hard work is lost.
因此呢，这个世界有很多人为神而工作，但是他们不知道神所喜悦的是什么，所以他们呢是呢，事倍功半。Therefore,
what does Krishna like? We have to learn that from Gurudev and the devotees, the Vaishnavas.
那么Krishna喜欢什么，我们应该从呢Gurudev和呢Vaishnava去聆听。Therefore,
anusilanam, there should be guidance, most importantly.
因此呢，anusilanam也指的在指导之下。
Anukulana. Therefore, this everything should be done in a mood, done for Krishna's benefit. Not necessarily for Krishna's happiness. Why? There may be some fault there. When Krishna entered the wrestling arena of Kamsa, that time, two big wrestlers, Chayan and Mustad, they wanted to kill Krishna by fighting him.
然后当时 Krishna 进入这个决斗场的时候，两个决斗士的，Chayan and Mustad想打他。They
challenged Krishna and Balaram. You should fight for the pleasure of the king.
他们挑战的话 Krishna and Balaram 说，你们为了国王的喜悦，你们应该打他。Therefore,
Krishna said, I'm a small boy. How can I fight with you?
那么 Krishna 说，我是个小男孩，怎么能跟你斗？
He said, we know you are not any small boy.
那么当时这些人说，我们知道你不是小孩。
And they grabbed him and fight him. They are pounding Krishna, choking him, punching him. And Krishna was also fighting with them. Krishna was very happy.
It
was a long time no good fighting. Does this mean those wrestlers were doing devotion? Because Krishna is very happy, some may say, oh, this is devotion because Krishna is happy. But no. They are trying to kill Krishna. Therefore, it cannot be called devotion even though Krishna is happy. Mother Yashoda, and on the other hand, Mother Yashoda sometimes she punishes Krishna. Threatens him.
Oh,
don't do that.
叫他不要干这个。
Dirty boy.
Oh, 脏小孩。
I won't feed you.
哦，不养你了。
Krishna is eating dirt.
因为 Krishna 有时候吃泥土。
Then Mother Yashoda chastises him.
那么Yashoda妈妈就骂他。
Oh, do that, my dirty boy.
哦，你这个脏小孩。
Krishna is crying.
那么Krishna因此的话呢，会哭的。
Some might say this does not look like devotion because Krishna is crying.
有人说，这看起来不像关爱服务，因为Krishna哭了。
But no, because Mother Yashoda is punishing Krishna for Krishna's benefit.
但是呢，不是的，因为Yashoda妈妈惩罚Krishna是为了他的好处。
If you eat dirt, then many seeds are there.
而且你要吃这个土，那么很多种子在里面。
These seeds will sprout and come out of your body, then you'll be finished. Then Mother Yashoda is punishing Krishna for Krishna's benefit. So even though Krishna is crying, the acharyas have said this is pure devotion because she is doing for Krishna's benefit. Also, there should be Pravritti Mulak and Navritti Mulak. some things which can be done for Krishna's, which are, some things are favorable for devotion, that is also devotion, and to avoid things which are unfavorable for devotion, this is also cultivation of devotion.
那么对奉献服务有益的东西呢，就是说避开一些呢不利的东西呢，都称为呢这个奉献服务。That
for devotees, we don't eat chicken or drink beer or take cigarettes or drink tea or coffee. Why? This is unfavorable for devotion. Therefore, not doing those activities is also cultivation of devotion.
所以呢，奉献者不喝酒啊，抽烟啊，不吃肉啊，没有呢喝咖啡、茶等等的话呢，因为这东西呢有利于，奉献者这东西有利于我们的奉献服务。
Because we're giving them up for Krishna's happiness.
因此，我们为了Krishna的快乐，放弃这些东西。
And what are the external characteristics of devotion?
那么呢，不爱服务的这个外在的这个特征是什么？
Anya bilasita sunyam jana kalmadi nabisam. True devotion will have no motives except for the desire to give satisfaction to Krishna.
那么纯粹奉献服务呢，没有其他动机，只是为了呢Krishna的快乐。
If someone is worshipping Krishna, oh Krishna, I need a new wife, I need a bank, I need some pay rise, I need a new car, my dog is sick, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. This is not pure devotion because you are doing some business with Krishna.
如果一个人唱诵哈利·克里希那的话，想得到一个新的妻子，还有钱，房子，还有别的东西，那么他这不是纯粹奉献服务。
Devotion has no motives except for the desire to please Krishna.
因此的话呢，纯粹奉献服务呢，没有其他动机，没有其他的目的，只是为了取悦Krishna。
The devotee will not practice, will not do any other activity except devotion.
所以的话呢，奉献者不会从事其他活动，只会就是说实践奉献服务。
No need Amitofu.
不需要阿弥陀佛了。
Meditation.
冥想打坐。
Yoga.
瑜伽。
Astrology.
还有的话就是现在算命的。
Forefather worship.
崇拜祖先，拜祖。
No.
不需要这些，只有奉献服务。
These are the external symptoms of pure devotion.
所以这是的话，纯粹奉献服务的这个外在征兆。
The Rupa Goswami has said Anya Bila Sita. Sita means sometimes there may be some emergency.
那么Sita的意思的话是有时候会有呢这个呢紧急情况。
Like there was one devotee of Krishna, her name was Draupadi.
那么譬如说呢有一个奉献者呢叫Draupadi。
One demon was trying to strip off her cloth.
那么有一个恶魔想把她的衣服扯掉。
She was trying to protect herself by her teeth, by her hands, by her husband, but no one would help.
她开始用牙齿，用手，拽住，还有请求自己的丈夫等等的，但是最后没有人帮她。
Then finally she cried, Hey Govinda, Rako Saranam, Aptava Jivatahari. Oh Govinda, protect my shame, please.
那么她最后呢，向主的，向神的祈祷， Oh Govinda, 请保护我的这种羞耻。
Someone may say, this is not devotion, because she prayed for herself.
因为有人说了，这不是奉献服务，是因为她为自己的祈祷。
The Rupa Goswami said, no, because this is an emergency.
那么呢，其实Rupa Goswami讲，这不是这样子的，因为这是一种紧急情况。
Therefore, some extraordinary circumstance.
所以呢，有这种特别的例子。
If someone comes to kill us, oh, Krishna, save me, then devotion will not be lost because it's an emergency.
那么呢，如果有人拿就是要杀你了，你这时候呢向Krishna说，Krishna救救我，那这不上的，你的奉献服务不会因此而丢失，所以这是一种特别的紧急情况。
Jnana Karmadi Anabitam. And that pure devotion should not be covered by materialistic fruit of activity or by knowledge.
那么这种奉献服务不应该被物质的活动以及被人格的支持所腐败。
Some people, they're so busy working, they have no time for chanting or hearing or worshipping or thinking or reading.
因为有的人有时候工作非常忙，没有时间再去聆听、唱诵、听经等等这些活动。
That means their devotion is now covered by karma.
那么这意味着他们的现在的奉献服务被karma被果报活动所覆盖。
Now bhakti is secondary.
那么这时候的话奉献被处于次等的位置。
But this should not happen.
但是这种情况不应该发生在我们身上。
Nobody can live without karma.
没有人可以脱离业报karma而活。
Even sitting here is karma.
就是坐在这儿也是一种业报karma。
Breathing is karma. Drinking, eating.
也是吃饭。
Yeah, but devotees, all their karma is done in a way which is favorable towards Krishna's service.
因此的话呢，奉献者从事这些活动，果报活动的话呢，是为了有利于他的奉献服务的。
And bhakti should not be covered by jnana.
那么奉献服务 bhakti 的话呢，也不应该被jnana所覆盖。
Three types of jnana.
有三种类型的jnana.
Tadpadat jnana, Kvampadat jnana. These two can be favorable.
那么前面讲的这两种就是说可以呢是有益的。
knowledge of Krishna and knowledge of the soul, this is not unfavorable for devotion. This is like, this knowledge is like a doorway to devotion. But there is another type of jhana called Brahma Atma Oritta jhana. Knowledge that people think the soul is one. The soul is this, what do you say? The soul and the Supreme Lord, there is no difference. That type of knowledge is very bad for devotion. Very dangerous. Like Buddhism, etc. And even knowledge of Krishna is God, even sometimes that may cover devotion.
有时候呢，说 Krishna 是神哈，这种知识最后的话呢，也会阻碍我们的哈这个奉爱。
Like in Vrindavan, there's the best example of Uttam Bhakti.
那么呢，这Vrindavan的话呢，是Uttam Bhakti的哈最典范的往事。
They're not serving Krishna because he's God, they're serving him because they love him.
那么他们服务 Krishna 并不是因为他是神哈，而是呢他们爱他。
Yeah, but the topmost example of Uttam Bhakti is the gopis.
因此的话，最顶尖的Uttam Bhakti的这个榜样呢，是呢牧牛姑娘的。
And of the gopis, Radharani is the best most example of that.
那么在所有牧牛姑娘之中的话呢，以那Radharani为至尊的。
So sometimes Buddha said, this verse defines the devotion of Srimati Radhika.
所以的话呢，这个Buddha也讲到了哈，这个世界描述的是呢，Srimati Radhika的哈这种呢父爱情感。
Sometimes this may be very difficult to understand.
所以有时候呢哈，明白这些东西呢很困难。
Don't worry, I had to hear 50 times before I understood a little bit.
我要听五十次哈，才能明白一点哈，所以你们不用担心的。因为呢，Bhakti是非常高的命题哈，是非常难以呢明白的。因此呢哈，Guru呢，无论到哪个地方哈，都强调这个细节哈。刚才。谢谢。
You were telling that devotees don't do yoga. Yeah, this is not bhakti. But at the same time, you were telling we have to do some karma, otherwise we cannot survive. Yeah, in this world, we have to do some work to earn for our family. So if a devotee does yoga to earn some money, and he does like that, and he engages that money in Krishna service, is this against Uttama Bhakti, or is this okay?
那么刚才的话，Srimad Bhajan的Prabhu呢也提到了哈一个问题的，就说在呢，咱们的话，使得转经也变成提到了哈，就奉献者呢，有时候也从事一些哈这个果报活动，包括维系家庭哈挣钱的等等，那么这算不算这种类型的东西在掺杂在里面，算不算呢哈纯粹的奉献服务呢？
那么，妈妈总解释到了哈，在这个世界没有东西是完美的。Yeah, but anyhow, there may be so many faults that we have to maintain our lives.
因此呢，有很多过失，但是我们要维系自己。And
use that wealth in the service of Hari Guru Vaishnava.
然后用这种哈挣来的钱哈财富的话来服务呢，Hari Guru和Vaishnava。But
if a devotee thinks I will open a butcher shop and I will maintain my life by opening a butcher shop, this will not be.
但是呢哈，如果一个奉献者说呢哈，要开一个屠宰场哈，以这种方式呢挣钱呢维系的话呢。
那么这是不利的哈。等苏德波萨米，看见牛，不是。阿苏德波萨米，bhakti yoga，priyojita，jnana se asu karakam jnanam prajatuhai。If this uttama bhakti is unpropagated, then very soon thereafter detachment from this world will come, and also all kinds of tattva jnana will come. That is bhakti yoga, because he will hear all these things from a bona fide Vaishnava or Guru. This is bhakti yoga. So he will know all kinds of tattva, Krishna tattva, jiva tattva, maya tattva, and everything. And he must be detached from worldly things like house, wife, children, and all his attachment will go to Krishna. Whatever we should do, they should do to please Krishna only. You are eating, I eating to please Krishna. That if I will eat, oh, after that I will have some power and then I will do bhajan. So everything should be done for to please Krishna. This is bhakti yoga. But even we are doing bhakti yoga, but we have no taste in hearing Hari Katha from any Uttam Adhikari or superior than us is telling Hari Katha. But we have no interest, no taste. Then it means that his bhakti is not pure. After some time, he will give up bhakti too. And he will be engaged in karma and nauda. So, he should have very much taste for hearing Hari Katha from superior. And then, वदन्ति तत्त्वविदः तत्त्वं जगज्ञानम् अद्वयम् ब्रह्मेति परमात्मेति भगवानीति शक्यते यो
那么啊，紧接着呢，师父给我说明就解释了哦。如果呢，无从法体啊这种神最高的奉献服务，如果能够恰当的执行的话呢，那么很快的，气绝这物质界哈这种呢。 各种的东西的话呢，挺自然会来的。那么呢，关于呢各种的塔图巴吉亚哈，各种的知识哈，这种真理的话呢，也会来的。那么像纯正的灵性导师呢，你去聆听各种练习，包括呢像基巴塔图巴哈，关于灵魂的知识；玛雅塔图巴哈，关于呢假象世界的知识；Krishna塔图巴哈，关于 Krishna 的真理的话呢，那么灵性这些东西的话呢，你就自动的哈放弃了尘世间那些东西的这些妻儿子女等等，而转向呢依附 Krishna。 那么我们做的所有活动呢，都只为了取悦Krishna。那么为了 Krishna 哈，我们吃东西这样子的话，我们有精力哈，才能够呢哈执行服务。所以尽管我们从事呢，但是现在呢，尽管我们从事奉献服务，我们对听经哈，却不感兴趣哈，没有品味。这意味着呢，我们的奉献服务呢是不纯粹的。那么一段时间后，一个人可能会放弃，也可能哈转向呢哈从事呢世俗活动。所以呢，从以我们修为高者那里呢去聆听呢。
经典的话呢，是相当的这个重要的。First, I offer my unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my most sociable Bhikshu Gurudev, Nityananda Tavishta Om Vishnu Pad, as Brother of the Sri Shriman Shri Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada.
首先，我向我最值得崇拜的哈，就是 Guru Nityananda Prabhu Om Vishnu Pad Astotasata Shishma Bhaktivedanta Swami
创造的这莲花主，尘土的哈，自于无限次的顶拜。同样的，我也向我哈最值得崇拜的释迦牟尼，Om Vishnu Pad Astotasata Shishma Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj。同样的，我也向我哈最值得崇拜的释迦牟尼，Om Vishnu Pad Astotasata Shishma Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj的莲花主呢，和他们的自于无数的顶拜。
For all of our disciplined succession and all the assembled devotees.
那么像我们整个哈，是个长期在座的奉献者哈，明白。Shri
Gurudev is continuing to explain the teaching given by Sri Supa Goswami to the sages of Nayanasaranya.
那么Shri Gurudev 的话呢哈，继续呢解释呢哈，Supa Goswami 呢向Nayanasaranya的这些哈圣者们呢解释的哈这些秘密。The
lesson is gone. Of how to be happy, how the soul can be happy by making the supreme soul happy.
那么也就是说呢，藉由呢，通过让自身所快乐的哈，令到我们的哈，灵魂个体灵魂哈，能终其呢得到快乐。
And now he is discussing the verse, Vedanti tat tat vidas tat vam, lej jnanam advayam, amati paramatmeti
Bhagavani Kishavyate. This verse means that those who are actually advanced in knowledge, those who are Vedantists, those who know the ultimate end of all knowledge have come to this conclusion.
那么他说真正有智慧的人，那些真正的超然主义者，那么他们达成了这一致的这个终极的结论。As
impersonal Brahman, as localized super soul, and as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Impersonal Brahman. Just like there are three ways to know the sun. One can see the sunlight and think, oh, I've understood the sun. But that is so limited. 那么就像我们有三种方式去查看这个太阳，有的人看到太阳光就觉得它知道太阳。 This is some knowledge, but it's not complete. Another person can go right to the sun planet and speak with the sun god and find out all about the sun planet.
Then
he automatically understands the sun disk and the sunlight. A mountain is also understood in similar various ways. From very far away, the mountain looks like a gray cloud. And if you get closer, we see it looks like a green lump. And then if we go very close and enter that mountain, we can see that it's full of so much variety. Trees and shrubs and birds and bees, different varieties of grasses. So the mountain seen from very, very far away is like the understanding of the sunlight or the impersonal Brahman.
所以的话呢，远看这个山的话呢，就像我们说的，认识，通过认识太阳光去认识太阳，或者说刚才说的，以非人格凡圣方式认识自尊主，所以
the all-pervading feature of the absolute.
那就是自尊主的话，就是这个绝对真理遍全万有这个特征被以这种方式给查出。
And the green lump is compared to getting a little bit closer and understanding that the Lord is manifest as the super soul in every living entity and in every atom.
那么以后，就是说，在定点的话呢，看到山是绿油油的一团的时候，那么我们就走进了这样的第二步，去极限性的超灵，明白绝对真理。
Directing the wanderings of all living beings who are situated on this body just like a machine made of material energy.
那么超灵的话呢，主导众生的活动的话，而这个众生的话呢，就像在这个。
And responsible for everyone's forgetful and remembrance. And entering the mountain is like understanding the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the source of the super soul and the impersonal Brahma Jyoti.
认知这个自尊性的神手，而这位自尊性的神手呢，就是这个非人格凡以及超灵的这个源头。
That Supreme Lord is called Advaya Jnana Paritattva, or the Supreme One without a second absolute truth.
那么这个绝对真理的话呢，就是独一无二的这个绝对真理。
Nothing in existence is separate from him or independent from him. Angani Yasya Sakalendriya Vritti Manti. He's non-different. All of the parts of his body can ask for any other part of his body. Although he's a person, he's not a limited person like us. Somebody may say there is difference in the absolute truth, because different parts of his body are different. But all of the parts of the body can ask for any other part. Simply by his breathing, he breathes in and out innumerable universes. By his eyes, he can accept all the foodstuffs offered to him. Also, somebody may say, well, he's different from all of his incarnations. There's so many incarnations of God. But they're all within him. They're not independent of him. All the spiritual universes, all the Vaikuntha planets, and all the Narayan features, they're all manifestations of him. He has Purusha avatars to create, maintain, and destroy the material universes. Yuga avatars who distribute the religion of each age. Past time incarnations like Buddha and Kalki and Ram. But they're all just like the different phases of the moon, half moon, quarter moon. Similarly, all the other incarnations are just partial manifestations of the supreme moon, Kalachandra or Krishna.
那么的话呢，就像月亮哈，有月相的变化哈，有呢就是说圆月也好，有满月，有上弦月、下弦月，那么其他的这些化身的话呢，都是哈Krishna，那么它的不同的感受哈，一个部分的扩大。And
somebody may give the argument, well, there are so many different kinds of energies, material energy, marginal energy, spiritual energy, they're all different from him too.
那么有人就争辩了哈，就说呢有不同的能量哈，内在能量、外在能量以及天气能量，那么这些能量跟主呢是有分别的。
But they're not independent of him. So Bhavati Jnanam Balakriya Cha, he has unlimited energies and they're working so well under his control that they seem to be working automatically. From his own existence, he manifests his chief potency. His supreme internal energy. Internal energy. Who is personified as Srimati Radhika. And there are three functions of that spiritual potency. Namely the spiritual world of all the spiritual planets.
那么包括的话，这个呢，灵性世界。
And the marginal energy, all living entities and all species of life.
也包括的话，边际能量里面的所有众生。
And the material energy, this gross, dull matter.
还有呢，这个物质的能量的话，这些呢，呆滞的话，实质的这个物质物品。
The tongue, other tongue, the or this material nature, seems to be more superior to the living entities. Controlling a living entity, even though the living entity is superior, all this is the inconceivable energy of the Lord. So by understanding that supreme absolute truth, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, and understanding that we are subservient, eternal, infinitesimal parts and parcels of him, And that our only duty in life is to serve him as the hand serves the stomach. And as one waters not the leaves and the fruits and the branches of a tree, but waters the root of the tree. So if we serve that Krishna, that Vasudeva, we become full of knowledge, full of renunciation under the guidance of Sri Guru. And our real self becomes unconditionally happy. Thank you.
In the conclusion, Sri Śrīla Gosvāmī is telling that if anyone wants to be happy, she should follow the principle of Bhakti Yoga. Without Bhakti Yoga, the service of Transcendental Supreme Lord, that is Krishna, only it can give happiness. Nothing else. And this Bhakti Yoga is very easy. Like Muslim brothers, not so many times up and down and so many things, like others, only Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram. If you are working, if you are walking, if you are cooking, at any time, you can chant it. No expense, nothing. In daytime, night time, in morning time, if even you are sick or anything, even you are not pure, you can chant this one. So Śrīla Gosvāmī is telling that we should hear the glorification of Supreme Lord Krishna. We should meditate him and we should glorify his qualities and everything, good activities. This is Bhakti Yoga. By this we can be happy, not by another, any means you cannot be happy.
那么如果任何人想得到快乐，那么必须追随呢 Bhakti Yoga 哈，奉爱瑜伽这个程序，也就是对至尊主 Krishna 的这个奉献服务，因为只有这样才能够带来快乐，没有其他方法。那么以这种程序，而这个程序的话呢是非常容易的，没有像其他瑜伽一样哈，你要呢做不同的哈瑜伽动作哈等等吧，只是呢唱诵圣名，无论你是走路哈煮饭，任何时间 都可唱诵，白天黑夜，没有念珠也可唱诵。所以的话，这种奉献服务呢，也包括呢唱诵冥想以及荣耀至尊主。那么由此的话呢，我们才能得到快乐。I
think that we are telling, discussing in very easy language that you can understand. And I think that you are understanding what we are speaking. If not, you can ask. You may have questions and we will answer.
那么我觉得我们是用了非常简洁的语言来解释这些命题的。我知道大家应该是能够明白的，如果大家不明白的话，可以提问。哦，是的。
Srila Gurudeva ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Sandeva Bhaktavrinda ki jai, Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Gurudev China Festival ki jai, Gurudeva Pranamanda. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Hare Krishna.
Hare 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 Hare
Radhe 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 Gau 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 Shri Radhe
Radhe Radhe Radhe Gau 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 Shri
Radhe 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 Gau Gau Shri Radhe
Radhe
Radhe Radhe Gau 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 Shri Radhe Jaya Guru Buddha, Jaya Guru Buddha, Jaya Guru Buddha, Jaya Guru Buddha.
Jaya Guru Deva, Jaya Guru Deva, Jaya Guru Deva, Jaya Guru Deva.
Jaya Guru Buddha, Jaya Guru Deva, Guru Deva, Jaya Guru Deva.
Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol.